Hello guys. So here is the Haven1 Airdrop claiming, and it has been listed on KuCoin exchange already. Like, it's currently trading on KuCoin. I can't really remember if it was on Satoshi app we mined this airdrop. I think we mined it on Satoshi app, so I can't really remember. But then I remember sharing the testnet guide where you have to connect your Web3 wallet so that you'll be able to get allocation for the airdrop. So now, if you connected your wallet, then if you have been following up on this channel and you did connect your wallet on this Haven1, then and you farmed the airdrop, then you should be eligible for this airdrop. So the eligibility and the allocation has been showing, and you can withdraw and send to KuCoin exchange to sell. So if you connected your Web3 wallet, if you are not seeing any allocation, it's either you did not farm or you did not connect your wallet, either or the two. So it's either you did not mine the airdrop, you did not participate in the testnet, or you did not connect your Web3 wallet. So if you connect your wallet, just paste the link to your wallet that browser, and you can connect and see your allocation. That's for those that farm this airdrop. So I've just pasted the link to my OKX wallet. You see, season one, thanks for being part of this part of the Haven1. Connect your wallet to see if you are eligible to the Haven1 airdrop. So I'll click on connect, and I can select okay, it's connected. Let's see. You see, claiming we end in 59 days. So if you are eligible for this airdrop, ensure you claim before 59 days end. Let me click on switch network. So if you are using OKX, this is advantage of using OKX. If OKX wallet is the wallet you connected, then you can see it will automatically add this custom network for you. So you can see add custom network Haven1 put up, meaning that this is a blockchain coin. They have their own blockchain. So you can see Haven1 mainnet. So I'll just click on confirm. They've automatically added the network for me now. Now I can now claim and send to to my wallet and withdraw to KuCoin exchange. So you can see everything is happening on OKX. I'm not adding network manually. Everything is automatic. So even if you connected MetaMask wallet, you can import your face key to OKX wallet and connect on OKX so that you can save your time from all this network adding. I don't know if MetaMask will bring the option on the app. If it's on PC, I can tell you it will bring. But for MetaMask app, I don't know. MetaMask app is not really interesting like that. So I prefer to use OKX wallet to MetaMask app. OKX app wallet. What am I supposed to say? So it's just the processing. So let's see so that I'll be able to claim and all of that. So guys, to claim this Haven1, you see you have to watch this video. So I have to click on claim to watch this video to the end. So I'll hold on for the next 1 minute 6 seconds to so that this claim button will be active. So as you can see now, the continue button has been highlighted. I can now click on continue. Then here is my allocation. The testnet. Okay, the testnet starts. I think this was a testnet. I just remembered. Don't mind me. So now, because I've automatically added the network, as I explained earlier, then I can click on claim and click on confirm claim. So you're not using gas fee. That's the advantage of having to mine a blockchain coin. So because this is a blockchain coin, they are deducting the gas fee from the token itself. So you don't need any gas fee to claim, meaning that everything you are claiming is yours 100% and you receive it to your wallet. As you can see, claim success. Put your H1 to work, farm 100% plus APR, end fees, and unlock even more in airdrop season 2. Don't just claim, multiply. So farm up to 100% APR, deposit H1 into the vault, no peering needed, start earning high yield, stake and earn up to 100%, boost your next airdrop. Your activities now falls
bigger reward in season 2. So now let me explain this part. If you are claiming, you can claim and deposit and stake to farm the season 2. This is just what UX Link did. For those that are familiar with the UX in season 2, you know you have to stake to earn season 2. Even the season 3, you stake to earn. So the same thing they're trying to do here too. You can stake the one that you've claimed now so that you can be eligible for season 2 airdrop allocation. They are trying to build a stable network. So if I click on this stake and earn, I can they will open another tab and I can be able to stake, even though I can stake directly from here as well. So now for those that want to sell, you can see lock, you can see H stake. If I click on this lock, I'll be able to stake this my allocation and earn more rewards. But firstly, let's see if my allocation is showing on my wallet so that I can show you how to sell to how to send to KuCoin exchange for those that doesn't want to stake. But if you are staking, remember you'll be getting the season 2 airdrop allocation as well if you stake. But if you don't want to stake, you can still withdraw to KuCoin exchange and sell to USDC. It's currently trading on KuCoin, and as you can see, here is the KuCoin exchange currently trading. Oh, it has dropped. Let's just say approximately this is 3 cents, 0.38, so we can approximate it to be like 4 cents. It has dropped, so take notes, you can sell here to KuCoin. When you come to KuCoin, click on this asset. You can click on asset and click on deposits, or you come to the home page and click on add funds. You click on this home page, you click on add funds. Then you can click on deposit crypto. If you click on deposit crypto, search for H1. You can see on KuCoin, this is H1. Having one network. Then you can copy the deposit address. Oops. Okay, here on KuCoin, you are seeing ERC20. Wow. So what they have on KuCoin is ERC20. Oops. So that means you'll not be able to deposit to KuCoin. Let me click on select network. It's only Ethereum network they are having on KuCoin. I think it's been listed on MXZ also. You should take note. Search for H1 on MXZ. If you are saying ERC20, then you cannot deposit ERC20. You cannot deposit the Haven1 network to this KuCoin because this is ERC20. You will not receive it if you deposit the one you claim from the website to the KuCoin exchange. You will not receive it because the deposit address here is ERC20. So what you can do now is either to wait, go and stake, or check MXZ. I think they listed this coin to on MXZ. MXZ Global Exchange. So you can search for this on MXZ too to see if what you are having on MXZ is the Haven network itself and not ERC20. Do not deposit Haven network to ERC20 address. You will not receive it. So for this KuCoin, the deposit is a no. Because you will not be able to get it. What you are having on your wallet is Haven1 network, not Ethereum network. So take note. So I think that's the correction here. So guys, I've checked on MXZ exchange and the Haven token is not yet listed on MXZ. It's only on KuCoin. And for KuCoin, it's only ERC network, meaning that you cannot send Haven network to ERC network on KuCoin. You will not get it. You will not receive it. So is it that you stake now and wait till the price increase and also till the Haven network to it, then you can sell by then. So I'll just proceed to go and stake because there's no how to sell at the moment except you want to bridge. If you want to bridge from the Haven network to ERC20 network, you'll be needing ETH as gas fee to send to KuCoin. You need ETH to bridge, and you need the ETH to send to KuCoin. So it does not worth it. If you ask me, I don't think I want to do all of that just because of how much. So I would rather stake it and lock it up so that I can also get season 2 allocation. Then hopefully in between those times of staking, they will add the Avi network on exchange listing. So for now, let me just stake. So to stake, I'm here on the lock page. I'll change it to H1. Then I will enter 100%. I'm staking now. Okay, let me remove 5 for gas fee. I don't know what their gas fee will be like. Let me just do 10. So you see, I've entered the amount I want to stake. Then I can scroll down and click on convert to ESH1. You scroll down below the page. You are converting your H1 to ESH1. Then I'll click on convert. You have to convert to be able to do the staking. And I'll click on confirm. And that's it. So what I'm doing here is to lock up my token, my reward, so that I can end the season 2 and also wait for the Haven network, yeah, added to the KuCoin. So now approve in wallet. I'll click on approve. But if you want to bridge, in case you have approve, okay, I'll click on confirm. In case you have ETH or you have, like, you earn a lot of this token, if you earn, like, I don't know, if you have like 10,000 pieces, you might decide to bridge to ETH network if you have. But if you don't have, just take. Don't stress yourself too much on that. So here, you can choose your lock period. You see lock period, enter lock period. 1 week, 1 month, 6 months, 1 year, 4 years. So depending on your lock period, will determine what you will earn. So this lock period will give me 244, your voting power, 244 voting power. And decay nearly, okay. That means it will end by next month, next year. Then what am I going to earn? I want to see. Let me do 1 month or 6 months. I don't know. What should I do? 1 year is too much. If I'm doing 1 month. So basically, just enter the amount you want to. The number of your duration. Either 1 week, 1 month, 6 months, 1 year, or 4 years. Enter it and scroll down here to click on stake. I'm contemplating between 1 month or 6 months on 1 year to stake. I'm contemplating. So that's it, guys. So this is the update about the Haven1 network. Basically, I don't see where you can sell here, except you want to make use of this H bridge. You can use this bridge to convert to ETH network, meaning you will be needing Ethereum as gas fee. The moment you bridge to ETH, you need the Ethereum as gas fee to be able to send out to KuCoin. So that's for this H bridge. With this H bridge, you'll be able to bridge your assets. As you can see, select. I'll click on Haven1 mainnet. Because I've swapped to that other one. Let's see this. So you see how the bridge works? Selecting from Haven1 mainnet to Ethereum, you can see. So if you know you want to send to KuCoin, by all means, you want to send to KuCoin to go and sell, then first of all, come to that H bridge and bridge from Haven1 mainnet to Ethereum, to Haven1 on Ethereum network. Then after bridging, you can send to KuCoin to sell. But if you do not bridge before sending to KuCoin, then it automatically means you will lose your token, because the one on KuCoin is on ETH network. So take note. So for myself, I'm not bridging. I'm not using my Ethereum to be bridging up. I just stake. So guys, this is the update on the Haven1 network. This is how to claim. This is how to bridge. This is how to sell.
And I do hope this settles the inquiry about having one. All right, guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button to my YouTube channel. Also, turn on your notification bell and you'll be notified of my back-to-back updates. See you guys on the next one. Join my Telegram community. Check the link in the pinned post in the comment section or the description box of this video. And you can also check the link for this having allocation, this thing, in the description box of this video. See you guys on the next one, and bye for now.